الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على أشرف الأنبياء سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد، طب القلوب ودوائها، ونور الأبصار وضيائها، وعافية الأبدان وشفائها، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد كلما ذكرك الذاكرون وغفل عن ذكرك الغافلون. اللهم رب النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، اغفر لي ذنبي وأذهب غيظ قلبي، وأجرني من مضلات الفتن ما أحييتني يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. وبعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا خير خلق الله. We have gathered here today firstly to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، and secondly to commemorate Laylatul Nisfi Sha'ban, the night of the mid-Sha'ban. And some of the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam which have been mentioned regarding this night. For instance, عن عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قال: يطلع الله عز وجل إلى خلقه ليلة النصف من شعبان فيغفر لعباده إلا اثنين، مشاحن وقاتل نفس. سيدنا عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما، not to be confused with سيدنا عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما. This is عبد الله بن عمر بن العاص. He states that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَطَّلِعُ اللَّهُ إِلَىٰ خَلْقِهِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this night, even though at all nights Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is يَطَّلِعُ, He knows of everything, but at this night Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His mercy forgives His servants in the midnight of Sha'ban. Except two people are mentioned that are not forgiven. One is Mushahim. Mushahim is someone who has hatred for another Muslim without no valid legal excuse. Hatred, even though the valid legal excuse gives you no right also to have hatred for the person, for another Muslim. What I mean by valid legal excuse is if you have any dealings with another Muslim and that person has broken the laws of Sharia and has broken his trust with you, you are allowed to mention that break of trust, that mistrust which that person has committed to another Muslim in order to warn him, but only to that extent. You cannot backbite, riba, make backbiting of that Muslim. But Mushahim is someone who has hiqd. Hiqd is dislike and hatred for no valid reason, no valid excuse. This person is not forgiven. And the second one is the one who kills a soul. A person who has killed a soul and has not repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, in other hadith, what is mentioned, this hadith is narrated by Imam al-Tabarani and Imam ibn Hibban in his Sahih, عن معاذ رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قال: يطلع الله تعالى إلى جميع خلقه ليلة النصف من شعبان فيغفر لجميع خلقه إلا لمشرك أو مشاحن. This one states that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives for everyone in the mid-Sha'ban except a mushrik, a disbeliever, and a mushahid, someone who has with another Muslim this life. Now, the exception to this is the Ahlul Bid'ah, the people of innovation. Because disliking them is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Disliking them is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this is referring to the Muslims who do not hold corrupt beliefs. Having dislike for them without a valid excuse is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive until you go and make up with that brother of yours. And another person who is mentioned in this specific hadith is a mushrik, a disbeliever. The Laylatul Nisfi min Sha'ban, the midnight of Sha'ban, it is also mentioned that a mudminul khamr, a person who is an addict of alcohol, is not forgiven on this night also. An addict of alcohol, someone who consumes khamr, alcohol. And remember, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كل مسكر حرام. Every intoxication is haram, prohibited. And this includes the drugs which people smoke, like hemp and weed and these other drugs. Any drug which intoxicates an individual is haram, prohibited. The sin is the same as the sin of alcohol. And in some cases, the drug is worse than alcohol because the drug affects the mind quicker than alcohol. Because the drug is more addictive, and in terms of effect on the mind, it is worse. This is why those people who smoke drugs or take any form of drugs should take heed of this in this night, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all his servants except the one who is an addict to intoxication. And this is one of the meanings of khamr. The meaning of khamr is also ma yukhamir al-aqla, that which intoxicates the mind. So anything which intoxicates the mind is haram, prohibited. And in another hadith, it is mentioned the one who cuts ties with his parents or is harsh with his parents. Because remember, the Sharia has not given any leeway for someone to be harsh with one's parents. This is another type of person which is mentioned in the hadith who is not forgiven in this night. Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha reports, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمَ فِي اللَّيْلِ فَصَلَّى وَأَطَالَ السُّجُودَ حَتَّى ظننت أنه قد قبض وسمعته يقول في سجوده أعوذ برضاك من سخطك وأعوذ بعفوك من عقابك وأعوذ بك منك لا أحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. فلما رفع رأسه من السجود وفرغ من صلاته قال يا عائشة أو قال يا حميرة أتدرين أي ليلة هذه؟ قلت الله ورسوله أعلم. قال هذه ليلة النصف من شعبان. إن الله عز وجل يطلع على عباده في ليلة النصف من شعبان فيغفر للمستغفرين ويرحم المسترحمين ويؤخر أهل الحقد كما هم. رواه الإمام البيهقي. This hadith narrated by Imam al-Bayhaqi. سيدة عائشة رضي الله عنها states that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam stood up in the night and prayed. And he made such a long prostration until I thought that his soul has been taken. And I heard him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam say in his sajda. Remember, making dua in the sajda is allowed in nawafil. According to the Hanafi school, making dua in the sajda in the fard is not allowed. In the nawafil, making dua is allowed in the sajda. And this was nafal. This is the dalil to pray nawafil in Laylatul Nisfi in Sha'ban. This is one of the dalail. She states that I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam say, I seek refuge bi ridaka min sakhati, with your rida. You know, we say rida Allahi wa rida al-walidain. What does this mean? The pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the pleasure of the parents. These are the two things which are sought for. Rida Allah wa rida al-walidain. And we know that paradise lies at the feet of your mother. This is a fact. And this is why we should take advantage of looking after our grandparents. We should take advantage of looking after our elderly people in our families. Because when they become really old, some of them are incapable of even going to relieve themselves and they need help and support. This is something we should take advantage of, even though it is difficult. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, I seek refuge with your pleasure from your anger. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, I seek refuge with your forgiveness from your punishment. بِعَفْوِكَ مِنْ عِقَابِكَ. And I seek refuge, أَعُوذُ بِكَ, with you, from you. What does this mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has attributes for which there are opposites also. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-qabid, the one who takes or the one who grasps things, meaning takes things away. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala is basit, the one who opens up things. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is muhyi, the one who gives life. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala is mumit, the one who gives death. So we take refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with His pleasure, from His anger. We take refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His mercy, from His wrath. بِرَحْمَتِهِ, we take refuge with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His anger. And this is something we ask for this night also, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompass us with His mercy and save us from His wrath. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, لَا أُحْسِي ثَنَاءً عَلَيْكَ. I cannot complete the praise of you. You are as you have praised yourself. When he raised his blessed head sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam from the sajda, from the prostration, and finished from his prayer, he said, O Aisha, and he called her by her nickname, Ya Humaira, do you know what night this is? She said, Allah and his messenger know best. Allahu wa rasuluhu a'lam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, this is the midnight of Sha'ban. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives special attention to His servants in this midnight of Sha'ban, and He forgives for those who ask for forgiveness. فَيَغْفِرُ لِلْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ and He وَيَرْحَمُ لِلْمُسْتَرْحِمِينَ. He places His mercy, special mercy, upon those who seek His special mercy. Otherwise, everything is covered in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already. But He provides His extra mercy for those who seek this mercy. And He leaves the people of hatred as they are. Meaning those people who have hatred in their heart for other believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves them as they are. This is why in this night, any personal grudges and any personal hatred we have for any Sunni Muslim, we should seek their forgiveness. And even personal hatred with a non-Sunni Muslim, personal hatred, we do not have. There's no such thing as a personal hatred which a person keeps. Rather, with, for instance, the Christians, it's a dislike for the belief of shirk which they have. And with the Yahud, it's the insult of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wassalam which they have, we dislike. For instance, those things which they have attributed to Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam. And Sayyidina Lut alayhi salam and other Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, like Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, in their religion. These are the things we dislike about them. But personal hatred, no Muslim has personal hatred or should have personal hatred for anyone in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this night, as is narrated by Imam al-Bayhaqi, is a night where it is also sunnah to visit the graveyard. In one riwayah, one narration, Sayyidatuna Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha mentions that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam went to Al-Baqiyah and Al-Baqiyah, the graveyard, Jannatul Baqiyah, the garden of Al-Baqiyah. It was known previously as Baqiyah Al-Gharqad. Gharqad is the buckthorn tree which grows in that region. And it is referred to as the tree of the Jews, because in the end of times, and this is now, the Yahud, or more precisely the Sayyidina, the Zionists, will plant these trees, and they are planting the box thorn tree all over Israel. Because when the Dajjal appears, and Sayyidina Imam al-Mahdi radiallahu anhu, and Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will attack the forces of the Dajjal, they will hide behind the buckthorn tree, because all the other trees will speak up, especially the olive tree, because the olive tree is the tree of the Muslims. And they will speak up. The rocks will speak up, and this is a miracle that will take place at that particular time. But the buckthorn tree will refuse to speak because it was referred to as the tree of the Jews. This tree is now being planted everywhere in Israel. At that time, Jannat al-Baqi' was covered in buckthorn trees which have been uprooted now. So the name remained al-Baqi', the area. But now we refer to it as Jannat al-Baqi', the paradise, because it is close to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, مَا بَيْنَ قَبْرِ وَمِنْبَرِ رَوْضَةٌ مِنْ رِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ. Whatever is from my grave to the minbar, the pulpit, is a garden from the gardens of paradise. This is one narration of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. So, visiting graves is a sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, asking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He forgives our sins tonight. And the people who are praying nawafil, if they have qada, they must make up fara'id. Instead of praying nawafil, you make up your fara'id that you have missed. Those people who have been missing prayers, make the intention today that you will not miss any prayers.